At a superficial level, media seems like an easy concept to understand. As discussed in the first day of class, it simply acts as an umbrella term for various ways of communicating different theories, ideas, and information. Television, radio, internet, and even the written word are all forms of media in this broad definition. However, after lengthy weeks of synthesis and abstraction, our limited minds have found that media is, in fact, a lot more complicated than that. Our first newfangled definition of media was discussed in McLuhan's text, Media is the Message. McLuhan uses many analogies to describe media, but the most relatable and understandable analogy is that of the electric light. Now, this image is supposed to be a GIF, but because Movie Maker is trying to fight me on this, it has to remain stationary. For that, I apologize. Anyway, McLuhan says media is an all-illuminating concept that allows the masses to absorb information easier, and it goes through four steps: extension, retrieval, obsolescence, and reversal. A form of media we have observed that goes through this process is that of film. From the first shadow plays that humans performed, it has been an extension of expressing emotions and ideas. As shown in what is supposed to be this GIF, even the zoetrope was used to show narrative. Later, however, this form of storytelling became obsolete as it was replaced by actual films, such as Sherlock Jr. and Journey to the Moon. At this point, it even furthered the idea of extension by extending the perception of the human eye itself. This was something we witnessed in Vertov's Man with the Movie Camera, for the entire film was essentially a more experimental view of daily life. From this point on, as the films evolved, it retrieved the initial idea of moving images by sequencing several smaller images together to form an actual video. Then, at its most advanced, film has reversed to some of its more primitive predecessors, and filmmakers today use the more modern ways to tell their stories. Now, as fun as moving pictures are, one of the next forms of media we discussed was that of stationary images. In Walter Benjamin's work, The Work of Art in the Age of Mechanical Reproduction, Benjamin discusses the issues of reproduction of certain images poses. He believes that every work of art, every photograph, contains an aura, or a specific experience and historical testimony that only an original piece can have. If an image is produced en masse, it ultimately threatens this aura and any authenticity it held in the first place. However, Benjamin considers that the perks of such reproduction, being that some historically important images can now be reproduced, with variants, thus allowing an ambiguity of both message and image. For example, this image combines several historically important pieces, such as The Scream, Girl with the Pearl Earring, The Mona Lisa, and even Van Gogh's Starry Night. This new image not only combines all of these pieces, but places them in a modern context by making these famous figures take an ussie, or a selfie with more than one person. The girl with the pearl earring is even chucking some deuces at the camera for an added effect. Though Benjamin's idea of narrative ambiguity was a bit more serious than this, this serves as a great example of what art can become when it is reproduced. It becomes a more relatable version of its original self, and though it may seem its original aura and historical testimony are challenged, it ultimately represents itself in order to be rediscovered by newer generations. This same idea goes for remixes, musical or otherwise. DJ Spooky explores this importance in his work, Rhythm Science. Rhythm Science is essentially his more technical definition for remixes themselves, which he defines as the reconfiguration and recontextualization of media. In this way, he is describing what Benjamin hoped would come from the mass reproduction of art and images. He believes that remixes are important for the purpose of communicating different messages using older media and making them more available to newer audiences. This also falls in line with Lessig's idea of remixes. In his lecture, he expressed the importance behind them, both musical and visual. He essentially stated that because the messages that lie behind such remixes are so pivotal to today's society, that the copyright on remixes should be more lax so that their ideals are not lost through infringement notices. Ultimately, Spooky and Lessig are on the same page, because they believe things like Vines remixing Donald Trump's speeches.
Hello, you people know a lot about trucks. Bing, 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 bong, bong, bing, 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 bong.
Are essentially acting as voices of our society. I see now that that idea is scarier than I had originally thought. Ultimately, even after learning all these varying viewpoints and theories, I've come to one important and somewhat obvious conclusion. Everything is media in some way or another. From an old photograph all the way to a glitchy Bethesda game, it all falls under the media umbrella. Each form of it carries its own weight, critique, and issues, and now I can't use any of these forms without thinking of each theory that follows it. I guess I can say, because of this course, I now know how to turn on the light.